Hey YouTube, this is Bill. I got some good response from the last video about the new JBL EON710s. So I figured I would make the follow-up video, and that is demonstrating a sound demo of a pair of them. So the key word, the key number on this video is $2,300. That's what this beginning DJ rig can cost you. And let me explain a little about it. So for my top end, I got a pair of EON 710s. Each one costs $500. So that's $1,000 for your tops. Pulling up the low end is the famous Bose Sub1 at $900. I really can't recommend any subwoofer at a lower price that could keep up the low end with the tops. I mean, there are lower alternatives, but I'm going to call this my minimum subwoofer. Of course, people like 15-inch, 8-inch subs, but I like the Sub1 because of its weight, portability. So, $900. Right here we have the mixer, which is the Mackie ProFX10. And I really think it's wonderful. I'm probably gonna make a separate video on that. $270. Again, you can get a less expensive mixer. And that's it, $2,300. So what are we comparing this to? So many beginning DJs who are playing weddings or gigs of 150 to 200 people max, I would say, on this system, let's say 175 more comfortably, they're looking for something, either a column array or a beginning DJ system like this, two tops and a sub. A good column array in this league would be a Bose Pro 16, which is $1,900. Okay, that's going to get you one column array, and I'm not going to do a whole video of the difference and advantages of disadvantages between column arrays and your typical point source speakers, which these are. Your other two choices would be the JBL PRX1 at $1,700 for one column array, and your EV50, which would be $1,800. And that's without the mixer. If you want to get the mixer model, then it's over $2,000. Actually, it's very close to this system, the EV50M. I believe it's $2,300. So that's pretty much what you would be comparing it to. Do you want to show up with one column array or these two budget tops for 175 to 200 people? That's your choice. I want to stress the fact that you see my speaker is set up very close together. I do like the subwoofer in the middle. If you have a choice, you want to put that subwoofer against the wall. Here I'm playing in a long hallway, and the subwoofer really doesn't have that reinforcement from a wall. So if you have that choice, you should do that. And I want to stress that in a normal situation, I would never be having speakers this close together. I'm just doing it again because I'm in a tight hallway here. But normally you'd want to keep those speakers about 15 feet apart, at least 10 feet to 15 feet apart. Amazingly enough, there is no power outlet in this hallway. So I have this whole system, two tops, a mixer, and the subwoofer, all running on this one little power unit, 15-pound power unit. And that is the EcoFlow Pro. I mentioned this in other videos, and I'll give the link down below, but it's really amazing that this whole system is actually battery operated, completely mobile. Very, very impressive. Here's the back of the Sub1, and I have everything set at unity on the mixer, everything ready to go for the sound demo. And I was bringing up the sub, and I brought it up to 2 o'clock, and I was still not peaking on red. So I didn't push it. I think I pushed it to 3 o'clock. It still was not on red. So this subwoofer can really has some headroom to it. Very, very impressive. So when you hear me demoing it, you're going to realize it's not even on red yet. You still have room on the sub. And that's the difference between the Sub1 and your less expensive alternatives out there.
So for the sound demo, beforehand, everything is set at unity. Everything is gain staged properly up to 0 dB on the mixer. The speakers have more room. They are not on red. Even at the volume you're going to hear play, it still has room. I already explained how the subwoofer has more room on it. I'm going to be using these hearing protection. It's going to be pretty loud. So again, I would not normally play at these volumes, especially in a tight little hallway like this. So the procedure I'm going to be doing is I have my subwoofer, and this is the way I like to do it. And again, I've explained this in other videos. I like to set up my subwoofer on an aux out. So the aux out is on right here, control room. So as I bring this up, that's going to be the subwoofer. And when I bring it up to 12 noon, that's about where I set it at max. Like I said, there'll be no red clipping at 12 noon. The sub is already at 2 o'clock. Probably I can bring this up more, but I'm not going to. But that's, I like to have the subwoofer on an aux out. So if the particular track needs more bass, I can just instantaneously just bring it up. If it's a quieter jazz tune and the bass is overpowering the tops, I can bring it down. So I know other DJs like to do subs on aux out. I really think it's the best way.
The Sub 1 at $900, like I said, is one of my favorites, but there's also a sub I've done videos about that could easily interchange with that, and that is the EV-ELX-200 12-inch sub, and it is the same price, $900, so either one of those two subs would work. This one's a little lighter, and if you want to go lower price, beginning DJs can't afford the $2,300 entry fee. You can substitute that Sub 1 or EV-ELX sub for the Behringer B1200, and that's really the bargain out there. It's only $330. It's a 12-inch sub. It puts out, but again, it doesn't have the clarity when you get to the high volumes that you're going to hear. But you can't expect a $900 sub to perform the same as a less than $400 sub. Also on the mixer, you don't have to use a mixer that's $270. You can go with a little Yamaha, the MG6 for $150. So that would bring down the system to a more reasonable price, more similar to your single column array, about $1,600 if you went with the Behringer and the smaller Yamaha. Okay, I think we're ready for a sound demo, and let's hear how this $2,300 setup sounds. And again, this would be my minimum that I would bring to any kind of paid gig of 150 plus people. Let's say 150, 175, max 200 people.
Six, almost 109. That is very, very loud in the home. Like I said, I was wearing hearing protection, so you guys heard it better than I did.
I'll have to listen to it myself on the video playback, but that is extremely loud. And as I mentioned, I want to reinforce this point. There is more room on this system. Nothing is peaking yet. Manufacturers usually say bring it up to red and then back it off a couple of notches, one notch or so. But I didn't find the red today. There's more room on this system. So very, very impressive. And the question I'll leave to you is, can a single column array for a similar price range meet this kind of performance? That's the question that the buyer would have to decide. And there's many pluses and minuses that may be a separate video I can go into. But very, very impressive for this price range, beginning portable DJ unit. And I have to stress again, this is actually all on battery power. If the battery couldn't handle the total wattage, it would have shut down. And as we speak, it did not shut down. It's still ready to go. Okay, summing it up. Again, the figure is $2,300. This is for a beginning DJ system that I would be comfortable to bring to a live gig, a wedding, small wedding situation, max 200 people. For that price, what are we getting? Okay, so let me just break it down. You got your two speakers, 500 each, $1,000. You got your subwoofer, Bose Sub1, 900. You need two speaker stands. I'm thinking $30 each. Decent pair of stands, $60 for the pair. And then you need a couple of three cables, two XLR cables and one cable for the sub. If you don't want to run the sub, you don't have to run it AUGs out. So I get my cables on Amazon, about $20 each. So that's $60 for cables. So that's where I'm getting. Oh, and then of course the mixer. That was the Mackie mixer. So altogether, $2,300. Can you do better? Did this sound better with a single column array? I'm not sure. I've never A-B'd them next to each other. It would be a great test for someone else online to do. This system at $2,300 is pushing very close to the Bose Pro 32 with the Sub1 package. I believe that is $2,600, $300 more. So there's a lot of choices out there. This is one of them. And of course, if you do want to add that external power source, that's going to be more money there too. So it's all choices up to the buyer. This is just one way to go. Hope you enjoyed. This is Bill. Later.